Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to more Delta Force. Or rather, should be welcome back to Delta Force. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Today's campaign is going to be Snake Eyes, and the objective is quite simple. Infiltrate the base camp designated objective Steam and steal a laptop computer. Now, while this says that we have to infiltrate it, we're just going to go ahead and go in loud and proud because, as we have seen, stealth is, well, pretty difficult in this game. And this game doesn't really want you to play it silly, as far as the level design and running layout is concerned anyway. And the layout of the objective seems pretty familiar. I've seen this sort of layout before, but anyway, we do seem to have some support, and there are quite a few enemy detachments here and there, but I suppose the support shall help us out with that. So, the execution. Your insertion point is approximately 450 meters west of Objective Steam. Follow your checkpoints around the hills to the other enemy camp. To the enemy camp. There's no other enemy camp. The laptop is suspected to be in the command tent on the southeast side of the camp. You're authorized to use whatever force you deem necessary to penetrate the camp and secure the computer. That's good. I don't need to use suppressed weapons. Your mission will be successful once you have obtained the laptop and arrived at your extraction point. Expected enemy forces. According to the information provided by Chad Army Intelligence, the camp is manned by 3-5 squads of CNLF troops. Chad National Liberation Front, I do presume. Approximately 18 to 25 men. SIGINT collected by J2 suggests that patrols around the perimeter of the camp are light. However, there may be several fixed watch positions overlooking the base. Allied support. Alpha team will be inserted approximately 150 meters northeast of the camp. They will precede you into the camp and eliminate their motor pool. Once you have obtained the laptop, they will assist in your egress to the extraction point. I'm sorry, I am unable to read today. Situation. Although the captured CNLF weapon was able to provide detailed information on how the hostage was tracked and kidnapped, he did not have any information on where the hostage is currently being held. After questioning by J2, the lieutenant did reveal the location of CNLF base camp, where a high-ranking CNLF officer is stationed. A high-ranking officer. Somebody even bigger than the lieutenant, I presume? J2 believes that the recovery of the officer's personal computer would provide much-needed intelligence on CNLF operations. Now, I wonder why we aren't capturing the officer himself. Anyway. The JFSOC, again, we get that term after a long time here, has authorized a mission to secure the laptop computer. Alright, so let's go ahead and change it here. Oh, I'm getting the saw. Now, I am sort of tempted to keep this weapon here. And given the sheer volume of enemy forces, I think this is not a bad choice. But for the sidearm, I would rather prefer to have the suppressed weapon to potentially keep the illusion of stealth going longer. And that's all. I mean, 0.22 and 0.45 in this game do the same amount of damage. One is just suppressed, the other is not. Neither of them have zoom capability and they're effective at, you know, equal ranges. So might as well choose the suppressed weapon over the non-suppressed one. And they also have, like, actually the 0.22 has more rounds, you know, per magazine as compared to the 0.45. And so that just makes the 0.22 the better option. Actually, because you can only carry like 3 magazines of both. Anyway, I digress. Let's just go ahead and start this mission. Attempt number 11, I guess? I have honestly lost count at this point. Not that I was keeping count, but I've lost count at this point. I have no clue what number attempt it is, but aside from the glorious sunset, I am using a sniper rifle to achieve my ends, because otherwise... Ouch. No. That is bad. That is extremely bad. You can die. There was another person over there, yes. And another person that I need to kill. There should be somewhere over here. Not there, no. should be somewhere over here on top of this hill here. Isn't there a person over there? There should be one. Because that person usually gives me a lot of trouble. Look at the birds just casually flying overhead. And yeah, I guess that enemy just never spawned this time around. Anyway, what I need to do is also take this guy out. The truck, I mean. You're dead as well, so that is good. Done and dusted. Not you. I probably should have took aim at this person who was shooting at me first. Because that, I believe, is more of a threat than the person who is trying to get into position to shoot me. And I do believe I'm taking up a lot more ammunition than I want to. Okay, that is a lot of firepower aimed at me, so I'll just gently move back a little and wait for these fools to come to me so that I can shoot them dead. Like, there's a lot of enemy presence, very heavy enemy presence in this sector. Where are these bullets coming from? Is what I want to know. There are enemies near me at this point, and I think that's primarily my own fault. There should be some more enemies over here as well. They should be a little farther. Oh, come on. As you guys can see, I'm not the best when it comes to shooters. Should be another person over here. Are you the person? No? At the base of the hill? You know what? One way to find out. Good. That is not what I wanted to do. Fuck. I accidentally opened the command console and made the game just a whole lot more difficult for myself. I mean, I could have died at that point. But yeah, that's just how older games are. I mean, you press the tilde button and the command console pops up. Nothing else to think about. That's all there is to it. Even those people came over to assault me. I was wondering why there's like a sudden surge in enemy activity over here. Shouting the nods. Okay. Time for us to move onward with our mission. This area seems to have been cleared, so we're good on this front. And my next order of business is to save my friends. And then the shit hits the fan is when I basically relocate and try to, instead of taking the fight head on, you know, fighting the fight from the same position where they expect me to be, I go somewhere where they do not expect me to be. I mean, that is the basics of sniper warfare after all. If you keep fighting the enemy from where they expect you, that'll only mean trouble for yourself. I do believe these two people are sitting in a fortified point right over here. And so is this person. And I have no idea why they decide to just, you know, leave their fortification and come running to us. Now my friends are behind that crevice over there, so I guess I'll start my assault from here, I suppose. Now, One of these times, there's a tent right here, and there's an enemy inside. One of those enemies just came right out and lasered me in the face with his handgun. And yeah, that's how it died one of these times. And stuff like that just, you know, makes me want to play this game in with the health bar option turned on. This is a good position for me, I do believe. Should be some people around here. Now, the reason that I don't like this place is that I have to expose myself quite a lot to get anything done. But luckily, we did capture a lot of, you know, enemies. Not capture, I mean we neutralized a lot of enemies while coming here. So I suppose that plays in our favor. But anyway, we do need to regroup and relocate before we continue on with neutralizing other enemies. There's nobody in here. There's definitely somebody in there.
In position. Waiting for your signal.
Good, 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 good. Go ahead, Bravo. Take care of the enemies for me, please. And make it quick. Choppy, snappy. Are they? No, they aren't. Can I? Ah, yeah, I can't see you. Too bad I can't hit you, though. Maybe that'll draw him out enough to the point where I can actually shoot him dead. Okay, time to relocate. I want to attack the enemy from a point where they're not expecting me. There seem to be lots of points like that here. Not that I can see any enemies at this point here, but yeah. My friends are doing their part, so that is good. I just hope that they don't die again. Now this position is one that I do not like because, it's very open. Leaves me quite exposed. Now I can, like, you guys can hear a lot of gunfire, but one thing you'll notice is that you can't hear the bullets whizzing past you, and that's because these guys are literally shooting from, trying to shoot you dead from inside their own tents. And I don't know whether it's a depiction of, you know, fear that they're completely unable to. They're completely unable to do anything apart from, you know, just blindly shoot in fear, or whether it is.
This is Alpha. We have a man down. We have a man down.
Be careful, Alpha. You're not invulnerable. And once you're dead, I won't have anybody else to assist me. So be careful, Alpha. I would rather not have any deaths on my watch, is what I'm trying to say.
Alpha to Bravo, secondary objective destroyed. Moving to assist you.
Okay, I suppose that kills everybody in that tent. So, and Bravo is right next to an enemy over there. I wonder what he's doing. Should be in right this tent over here. Somebody's shooting right at me, meaning that they can see me. And I'm willing to bet that they're right inside this tent here.
Bravo, King 6. Check the commander's tent for the package.
Bravo, King 6. Copy, Bravo. Copy, King 6. Bravo proceeding to the objective. Huh. I wonder if that was designed to be crate for me to, you know, fill up my ammo from. But yeah, there's an enemy inside. And I suppose one of the best ways of dealing with them is to just ship a nade in there. Well, that kills them dead. Clip here for the deagle, the desert eagle. And there seems to be an enemy inside this tent. Yes, yes there is. Except this enemy can actually shoot through walls and stuff. And that takes care of every single person in this map. At least at this point, I mean, everybody's alive at this point, and that, I do believe, is all that truly matters. And I have to jump over this thing to... No. Oh, thankfully, I don't have to jump over anything at risk. That is the laptop, yes? I do believe that is the laptop? Yeah, thank you.
Package is secured. Proceeding to extraction point.
So, yes, sir.
Blackwood to Bravo. Move to primary extraction point. We'll meet you there.
Got you, sir. Alpha 2, follow me. Although I'm not your team lead. I'm the Bravo team lead. The only person in Bravo, which by default makes me the team lead. But you're a man short, I saw. So, yeah, maybe I could be a leader. Come follow me. Don't do that. No, lollygag. Don't do that around. No. Where's the healer? Where is the healer? I can just hear the sound of the healer. I can't see it coming. Where's the healer? Oh, there it is, you little badass. Look at you.
King 6, we've made contact with Bravo. The package is secure. Repeat, the package is secure.
Come on, Talon, don't be shy. I need to get on. Come on. Anyway, that's the end of the mission, finally. I don't know for how many tries. And, yeah. 40 kills. 40 entire kills. This was a tense mission, and this was a difficult one. Bravo team has successfully obtained the objective, despite heavier than expected resistance at the enemy camp. No shit, genius. The CNLF laptop was captured. The information contained in the computer was immediately decoded and has revealed the location of two key CNLF bases. A command, control, and communications C3 base, and a training base. Bravo team has been put on standby alert, while JF SOC decides which of those bases should be assaulted first. Oh, good to know. Good to know. So I'm guessing I'm JF SOC, because I have to decide which of these bases I want to assault first. But anyhow, the next missions in the Chad campaign are Dust to Dust and Metal Hammer. So this is the C3 post, the communications post, and this would be the enemy training base. And I like how they say pacify the enemy training base, because they're all trainees, they're still younglings. So yeah, they just need a pacifier. That was it for today, and that was a long attempt on my end. I mean, I'm pretty sure the video would have seemed pretty short, but I think I've been retrying this mission for 11-12 times, and right before I reach the end, somebody or the other just manages to kill me. So yeah, I'm glad it all worked out in the end, and yeah, thank you for watching. The next time we come around, I think we'll do Dust to Dust, or maybe we'll do Metal Hammer, who knows. But at any rate, until then, take care. Farewell, fellow things.